Excellent. Well, today is March 26. It is 9 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, and we are talking the sales development market map, the sales development landscape, version 5, and how to use this thing. It's a great, wonderful tool, and it's a pretty thing to look at and send around to all your friends, but how do you actually use this as part of setting your strategy and getting the program going? So that's what we'll dive into today. We'll do maybe 10 minutes of just kind of chatting through this whole thing, and then we could do some Q&A and hopefully get you back to work here in a reasonable time period. So before I start, I've got calls coming in, so I'm gonna mute that. And again, my name is David Delaney, over here at TenBound, and we're a research and advisory firm that focuses really on the sales development industry. Everything that goes into the SDR and BDR world. And as you can see, you know, it continues to evolve and grow, and potentially now with the situation we're going through, contract, and we'll be tracking that. And the reason that we put this market map together and also the directory is to be able to consolidate and get a larger view on what's available out there to help with the strategy of running a sales development team, and to be able to try to bring it all into one place. And so we started this about 2 years ago, and if you look at sort of an evolution of the map, it's grown significantly. And even new quadrants have been introduced to be able to help put the sales development program together. And when I look at this, it's like, okay, again, this is great. It's got a lot of pretty pictures, but how do I actually use this? So where I would start with looking at the market map is if you're looking at your sales development process and you're pretty strong in a few areas, but there are some areas of the process that are weak. There may be some tools or services that you could plug in and help move the program forward, either on a program basis or just with a point solution. And what we've tried to do is bring these all together into one place so that you don't have to go to a bunch of different sources to find that information. And, what we see, a lot of times in the clients that we work with is that they put together the process, based on just plugging in one of the major systems, and there's no sort of documented process behind it. So it's basically plug in a technology and start to use it to the best of your ability without really mapping out a process. So we definitely start, get the process down first, and then plug in the specific tools that will help you so that you just don't have a bunch of stuff plugged in randomly and not necessarily supporting what you're trying to do. The bread and butter, of sales development, and what we've seen grow over the last few iterations of the program is obviously the data component. We call the data component the heart, the oxygen really of sales development. And if you don't have great data, you could end up spinning your wheels to a tremendous extent. And so most of the major players are on there. There's always new ones coming up, and definitely when it comes to data, that's one of the, we could talk about that for the next hour. and by the way, if you've got any questions or anything, I got the chat up here live and we can take that. We got a shout out from Derek for HD Data. Great program. Definitely one to check out, one that's been on here for a while. And it'll be interesting, as we go through this time period to see who survives. And, it's really focusing on how great your product and service is and how it's serving customers and how, you know, critical it is to the stack to see who makes it out of this situation. But we'll always start with data. Data is obviously, you know, a huge component. That's one of the first things people look at. And then over here, you can see that the sales engagement quadrant continues to expand. It's sort of the lifeblood of sales development. And we see more and more of those companies coming into the market. You know, they just like 5 or 10 years ago, before the advent of sales engagement, probably nobody remembers this that's on the call, but we had CRM, right? And CRM is great for organizing the information that you have, but it doesn't necessarily lay out what the SDR is supposed to be doing during the day. And then with the advent of all the sales engagement platforms, we got that cadence, that rhythm, that sequence that started to support them. So, you know, sales engagement is huge. There's always bleed between the quadrants. So it's interesting now that most, you know, a lot of the CRM companies are offering sales engagement either natively as part of their program or, you know, as a plugin. And we see a lot of the sales engagement companies potentially just becoming CRM. So you don't necessarily even need a CRM. You just go with the sales engagement and it has all the functionality that you need. One example today, I have a call set up with Salesforce, and a lot of people don't know this, but they actually have a sales engagement platform that they're building and they built, it's out in the wild right now, called Salesforce High Velocity Sales. So, you know, it's interesting that when you look at all these companies, that the point solutions are just killer at what they do. You know, they're amazing, or they wouldn't last very long. But you have to plug them in and integrate them with your existing CRM. So it'd be interesting to see how the big CRMs start to, if they can compete with the point solutions to make a killer product that satisfies the needs of the sales development community. So I'm interested to see how that plays out over the next year or two, because like we said, there's a lot going on. The other couple of quick things on version 5 that we thought were interesting to take a look at is there's just been this explosion in the outsourced industry of sales development. And we ran a research study recently, that's available over in the research center. There's a free executive summary, or you can get the full report. But we were trying to figure out, you know, looking at this explosion of services, you know, how do you whittle down who's a real company and who's, you know, not a legit company, and give you some advice there. But one thing that I notice about this is that there's this humongous demand in the marketplace for sales development. And people realize that it is very, very difficult to set up a sales development program that runs correctly and is predictable for a variety of reasons. I'm sure everybody on the call, you know, lives those reasons on how hard it is to do this. And there's still sort of a mindset at the executive level. I think it's going away. I mean, if anybody's got half a brain out there, that the mindset is that, hey, sales development, you know, it's an entry level position. It's, you know, plug and play, just hire some people and give them a list of names and they'll get it done. But as we all know, I mean, if you're listening to this, like, it is so much harder than that. And it's very strategic. And, you know, it's hard for companies to get it right. So to fill that demand, you know, as an executive, you're sitting there going, do I build it in-house or do I just buy it and get, you know, one of these companies to come and help me build my sales development program, because that's all that they do. And so the response from the market for that huge demand is an explosion of these outsourced companies. And so there's a guide available if you're thinking about vetting out one of these, and some questions to ask. My friends over at SalesSource And at the sales developers also have put out a guide for thinking about how to get involved with one of these companies. But it's interesting how many there are and maybe how many will last through this current situation that we're in. We just continue to see that quadrant explode. Couple of quick things is we added a new quadrant right now for version 5 encapsulating communities, because just that word is kind of a buzz in the space right now, and people are pulling together more online to acknowledge that community support that we all need. But there's some great ones that we're hearing about that are coming up. Obviously, AAISP has been around for a number of years and has a great local community. Revenue Collective is definitely coming up with more of intimate settings. Sales Hacker, is the granddaddy. It's almost like a media company, but its initial roots were in the community. We had Bravado over in the referrals section because initially we had it categorized as a way to get referrals over to people. But my friend Sahil Mansouri, let me know that, hey, that should also be in the community. And right now, if you go to Bravado, there is a strong digital community growing and expanding there of people supporting each other, helping each other out, and trying to, right now it could be jobs, if right before the call, I got a call from somebody who they just like laid off half the company. So leaning on those communities and finding those communities. If we missed any, let us know, because I'll give you a resource to be able to let us know about that. So some growth in some of the other areas, those are the major trends that we've seen with version 5. More growth in data, huge explosion of outsourced services. We see that continuing. Number of sales engagement programs and some crossover to CRM. Bunch of communities coming out to help support each other. Other quick thing that we've seen, and if you've been around for a while, you've seen this, is in the sales education quadrant. There's a number of companies out there that are almost, they kind of blend between finding, raw recruits out in the marketplace, putting them through like a boot camp, and then liaisoning with the companies to be able to place them. In some respects, almost acting as like a recruitment filter, and definitely great opportunities both for the people that are out there that are looking for jobs and looking to break into the SDR industry, but also a great opportunity for companies anonymous attendee, there are a number of key vendors missing from this map. How often is it revised? Dude, we just revised this. This is like while we're having the webinar. We revised it it came out like 2 weeks ago. And just to clarify, this is only for sales development. So here at Tenbound, we're 100% focused on sales development, which is the SDR, BDR world. So there's other market maps out there that cover sales from the SDR world all the way through quote to cash and customer success. And then there's like the granddaddy, which is the marketing MarTech 5000, which encompasses like a gazillion different marketing automation tools. So I just want to clarify that if the vendor or the product or service is related to the SDR, BDR world, and they're a legit company, we want to get them on the map. So whoever wrote that, if you just want to shoot me an email at david@tenbound.com with anybody that we missed that's relevant to sales development, then we'll check it out and we'll get it on we're already working on V6 right now. And we release these once a quarter. So we definitely want to get it on there. The other thing too is if you, whoever wrote that is actually a company that wants to that's involved in sales development and wants to ensure that you're on there. The other thing I wanted to talk about today was we released a directory. So you know, people were like, "Hey, this is great. You have a market map, but how do I double click on this and get more information about the companies?" And so if you go to 10bound.com market dash map, and you just go down, you can download the high res PDF that we were just looking at and get this. And then this is so, so hard to do because I usually have my right hand woman, Hannah, helping me with the questions and stuff, but she's out on maternity leave right now. So I'm riding solo here. So bear with me. I know another question just came in. So you go to this, and then down here, there's a directory, right? And so what the directory is, it's like, okay, great. Like I know that I want to shortlist, some of the companies that are in the outsource service. So I want to go, you know, talk to like two or three of these companies. You can go over to the directory, and then click on this, and it'll bring up this page right here, which is the market map directory, and you can start to look at some of the different options here. So, for example, here's a great page that was filled out by a company called Connect Leader. And what we try to do with the directory, right now it's V1, it's very beta. Like we just wanted to start getting companies up here, and we actually already have 100 companies that have started to fill out their profiles. And so if you're one of those companies and you want to fill out your profile, I'll show you how to do that. But so this one's really good. So it's Connect Leader. It's we just want the facts, ma'am. You know, if you ever heard that one, we just want to know three things real quick. I don't want like the whole sales pitch. Just give me the value prop. How are you different than the 27 other companies that are in there? And then give me a few case studies. Let me know who you worked with before. Just three things in 3 minutes. And basically, we're also going to do a video series with any of these companies that want to come on, and it's just like the 3x3, okay? Three things, value prop, differentiator, and case study in 3 minutes, go. And eventually we'll have a little wireframe down here where you can post that video and get that going. Over here, we're gonna populate some of the other companies that are in the map that have a directory page. So you could potentially start to save and shortlist. And we're also going to get a contact button here if you're just like, okay, this looks good. This is my, you know, my industry, and looks like a well-established company. Cool. All right, contact, boom. Let's set something up. So, the opposite, not to call anybody out. I love these guys, but I think this one, needs some work because just be sure if you're one of the companies that are on there that you fill in the profile as completely as you can. Just give me a value prop, competitive differentiator, and a case study, because otherwise this thing's pretty barren. And it doesn't give people a lot of info. So the workflow might be, hey, these look pretty good. Some of these look pretty good. Let me go check these out and just type it in. And if they're in here, they're gonna show up, in the directory. And if they're not, then we gotta get them in there as soon as we can. So the way that you would do that is if you went to the market map and you didn't see the company, you could just register. It's free. It's not, there's no payment for any of this. Register the company. It takes like 2 minutes to set up the page. And then next time you come back, you can just log in here and update it more. Get some pictures or some people put up like screenshots and stuff like that in the images. A few screenshots of if it's like a software. And then again, we're just building out. You'll be able to contact them and save, so that you can shortlist it. So I know I had a question come in. I wanted to make this like a very casual, thing. ABM organization section really needs some work. All the vendors included are nothing more than channel point solutions. Demand base offers display ads, not sales development. Huh. Okay. Cool. So duly noted, we need to work on the ABM orchestration side. Okay, cool. So that's what you got. You go over to 10bound.com, go to research. You can click right here on the market map or go over to the directory. If you want to get that outsourced guide that I mentioned, you can just click here on the research page. And I mentioned that there'd be a free gift for everybody that jumped on today. We compiled this as a CSV file, and we're actually selling it because we had to put in a lot of work on it and pay a lot of people to get it together. But if you email me at david@10bound.com, I'll send you a free code, and you can download the CSV file for free. So that's how much are we selling it for? Let me see here. It's a $400 value, folks, just for spending some time on the webinar. So that's pretty good. I'm losing my shirt here. All right. So market map is over on the market map page right here. If you want to double click on it, just cruise over to the directory. If you don't see your company in there, go ahead and register it. And anonymous visitor person, thank you for your feedback on there, and we'll look at the ABM orchestration section in more detail and make sure that it's relevant to the sales development world. I obviously, after this, need to do a demo with DemandBase because I thought that they were supporting sales development and had tools and processes to get SDRs in front of the right accounts, but that could be wrong, and we'll go back and take another look at that. So unless there's any further questions or anybody's got any thoughts, appreciate you taking the time and learning more about this. We're here to help, and you just shoot a comment or contact us if you want any advice or some of the research on sales development to help you get you through this tough time. And sure hope this is helpful, and we'll talk again real soon.